Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we are working on under graphic design concept tutorial. We'll be creating out this 3D extrusion text effect in Adobe Photoshop using Depth Map, and we want to create some amazing text effects like this glow and this smash effect. So we're going to create this using very simple techniques. In the previous video, we have seen how you can create a blend text effect using the blend option in Adobe Illustrator. We have used a wrap tool and we have applied grid map in Photoshop, and as well as we have created a second design where we have used the shear transform tool to give some perspective look to the text and use blend option to create that. In this tutorial, we're going to create out this amazing 3D extrusion text effect. And then the first design we're going to create is this X, where we'll understand the concept behind this design. So like, we'll be typing out the text, we'll be using the 3D extrusion depth map option to create this effect. We're going to add noise, we're going to add like wavy effect to give this nice detail, and after that we'll understand that concept and apply to our first design, that's this mesh, where we have created this nice 3D look to our text, as well as we're going to create this like extruded text where you can see it's let me check it out. Let me show you how it works. So if I use this 3D rotation tool, and you see it's like extruded outward, and this is like the extrusion outward where the background is black and our text, which is bright color, is extruded outward, where in this smash option our background is white. That means the colors which are little darker are going to be extruded inward, and this will give you this interesting look to the design. So let's look at how we can create this design. So I'm going to open a new Photoshop document. So let's open a new Photoshop document for this, and for this design I'm going to keep the size little bit smaller, so around, let's give it around 1000 by let's say 600 pixel, and keep it resolution 300 and create okay. So this is our artwork. So let's begin. So first thing is to understand the concept. So I'm going to show you with a very simple example. So I'm going to type out letter X, come on, X, and this is it. So let's choose a bold font for this. So I'm going to choose a bold font from the collection. So I'm going to click on there and let's choose some thick bold font. So let's choose something bold. Okay, let's say you have selected this. Okay, this looks great, bold, and it's very bold. So let's try it out in this design. So click, and here it is. Now the first thing we're gonna do is to apply the RGB color. And if you check out over here, the basic things which we have done in this designs are we have applied RGB modes and given this nice design look. So if you check out X, it's RGB, red, green, and blue, and combination of these three colors has given this effect. So let's apply it to our design. So this is the text. Let's double click on this and let's give red color to this. So this is our layer, this is the R layer channel. Now create another duplicate of it, and for this I'm going to give G, this is the G channel, and now I'm going to create one more duplicate for blue, that's B. So double click on this and give it blue and click OK. So we got all the three layers. Now if you move around any of the single layer, it will give you a nice look. So let me select this first layer and just move around. So you can see we got a red on the top and blue on bottom. I'm just moving it down by using the arrow keys in your mouse. So this is it. And if you check it out over here, this is the look we got. So this is it. For this, I'm going to keep it this much, and we'll use blue and red, that's all. Or you can, if you want to keep the blue on top, you can do that just using this, or you can just move it down and just move it on this side like this. So let's keep it like this. So we got this interesting color combination. I'll just select everything like this okay, and just convert them into smart object, so that we can go in there anytime and edit the text. So convert this into smart object, and we got a single for X layer. And now we'll apply some effects like a little bit of noise and a little bit of wavy around the edges, so that will give you this details in your design. If you apply it directly, let me show you what it looks like when you apply it directly. So I'll go to 3D and new mesh for layer, and we'll go to depth map and apply plane. And if you see over here, you'll see the design looks very clean. Let me show you. So here is the design which is just the rendered version. I'll just click over here and I'll just choose unlit texture, and this will give you that original color tone effect. And if you move around, you can see it's very clean. I'll just zoom it in for you, like zoom it in, and you see there's very less details. It's smooth and clean compared to our original design, which is you got that nice like extruded textures in your text. So we're gonna try to achieve this details in this X as well. So let's do it. I'll just Control Z to get back to our original layer. Control Z, Z, Z. And here it is. So let's add some noise first. So we'll go to filter, noise, add noise, and here we'll give some minimum noise here. So I have given around a 5 amount, you can give it, but we need a little bit of noise, that's all. So I'm gonna give okay, this is the noise, right? Now we'll add some noise like wavy effect along the edges, and for that we'll go to filter, then the start wave, and here we under wave we're gonna give the generator number of generator to very minimum, because if you increase it you can see we got lots of distorted edge. So we're gonna give it around 1 for this, and for the wavelength we have given very minimum, like 2. If you increase it you can see the size distortion is very huge, we want it very little, so keep it 2 and click OK. And here we go, we got that nice distorted edge lines. Now if we apply 3D, now we'll go to 3D, new mesh for layer, and depth map to plane, you can see that effect there. So and here we go, and now if I right click and choose unlit texture, you see the original texture there, and if you rotate it you can see we got that nice texture details in there. And if you want to zoom it in, you can just zoom it out and just click there and use this arrow keys to bring it in. So just zoom it in like a little bit of down, so we didn't wait for that, and here just move it down a little bit, and we'll just use this other arrow key just to move it on the right side like that. And now using the rotate tool, this 3D rotation tool, just click on the outside and just rotate it, and you can see you can give it to any angle you want. So let's keep it something like this, okay, and I'll just use this to move it somewhere around here. And if you click outside, you can see you got that nice detailed look to your design. And that's how we can create, we can apply this effect, this 3D extrusion depth map effect to any font, any text you like. So this is just an example. Now let's see how we can apply it to a real font, real text, or real word. So the first example I want to show you is this layer, this smash word, and let's say you want to apply this effect to your smash text. So let's add a new layer, text, type out smash, I'll just hide this and apply alt backspace white color, and let's type out smash S, and let's choose a nice font, like smooth curvy font. So I'm gonna go to text, or maybe just select them all and go there and choose something like this. So this is the font we're gonna use. This is a Amsterdam font, you can apply it there. And now let's apply the effect. So it's the same technique, we're gonna follow the same steps. For this first example, what I'm gonna show you is this. We're gonna extrude it inward, that means we're gonna use this text and extrude it inside the background. So for that, your background should be white color, and whatever the color of the font is, which is little darker, it's going to be extruded inward. If you keep the background black and set the text to lighter colors, it will be extruded outward. For example, here as you can see, this one we have extruded inward, that's why, because our background is light and the color shades are little darker, it's extruded inward. If you go over here glow, you can see the background is black, so extruded and the text are lighter color, it's extruded outward. So it's the simple concept. So if you want to give effect to your text where you want your text to be extruded inward, your background should be bright color. Now let's apply the RGB. So I'm going to double click on this and set it R for this, okay, then I'll create one more duplicate and this one for G, so just check G, okay, then we'll create one more duplicate, this one is for B, so I'm gonna check B and click OK. So here we go, now let's do the placement. So we'll move this blue here around here like that, Or maybe I'll just Command or Control T and just extend it on the vertical direction like this. Okay, enter. Now I'm gonna like move it a little bit downward, a little bit, just to give it some effect. And I'm gonna choose the top one, which is the blue color. I'm gonna just move it around, and you see it'll give some cool effect with your yellow colors. So what we'll do is we'll just try to bring in a little bit of yellow to your design and move a little bit upward. And that's how we have added that nice yellow, blue, green, all this color mixed together very well. So here is now. Let's apply the same effect. So I'm going to select all these layer, text and the background, convert them into smart object. That way we can go in anytime you want and change the text and it will be applied automatically. So let's do it. Now, the first thing we're going to do is to add some noise so that these noise are going to give you details. So that's why we'll go to filter, noise, add noise. And here we'll set the noise to minimum around 5 amount, and it depends as per your document size, because my document size is little less, that's 1000 by 600 pixel with 300 dpi. If your document size is huge, you need to increase the value of noise larger, so it depends on the size of your document. So this time mine is 5. Now let's add this distort option. So we'll go to wave and we'll set the distortion value to minimum. So I have kept the set generator to 1 and the wavelength to 2, and just randomize it and click OK. So if you zoom it in, you can see the edges are a little wavy look. So it has distorted the edge line, and that will give you an interesting texture to your text effect. So we'll go to 3D now and go to new mesh for layer and apply that map to the plane. Just give it a time, and here we go. It's, as you can see, it's already extruded inward. And the next step we're gonna do is to right click and set the style to unlit texture, and this will give you that original color tone. So here it is. Now you can just zoom it in your artboard, and you can just use the rotate tool just to move around like this. Okay, so let me zoom it in a little bit. So using the this tools and click over here, you can use this direction and just bring it inward, and you can zoom it in. And now using the rotate tool, this 3D rotation tool, I'm gonna just rotate it just to give that interesting look. And here we go, this is the final design, and it's so simple to create. And after this, you can just move around using this tool. You can just zoom it in or zoom it out as per your requirement. Okay, just place it in the center, and here it is. And this is the second design, and here's the first design and the second design. It's very simple. Now let's look at the third design, and we'll follow the same steps, just the color combination is going to be different, and it will give you a different perspective to your like text effect. So let's create that. So I'm gonna create one more layer and apply black color. So I have applied black color to this layer. I have applied this background black color here. So I have used the shortcut command backspace or control backspace. And now let's create a text. So I'm going to choose text, choose white color for this, and just type out GLOW glow. We'll just scale this down a little bit, command control T, and just scale it down and place it somewhere around here like that. And now let's choose a bold font for this. So I'm going to choose, okay, so I think this looks great. This bold is looking great. This is bold and this looks great. So we are trying to achieve this effect. This is the effect we are going to achieve. And to create that, we have applied a black background and choose white color for the text. So just scale this up a little bit and let's place it in the center. Now the next step we're going to do is to create the RGB layer. So the first layer is going to be R. So I'll just uncheck G and B and click OK. Let's duplicate, and we'll create the second layer, that's G. Do the third and set it to B. And let's do some movement. So for this color here, we have used yellow, red, blue. So let's do that. So I'm going to select this and just move around just to see the effect. So red is on top. That's fine. Okay. And I'm going to move the second layer just to give yellow tone to this. I'll just move it on this side a little bit just to give that effect here. And we'll just move this red around here and this yellow something around here like that. Okay. This is looking great. This is the way I want my text to be look like. As you can see, I have moved around the blue, layer and the red layer and rearrange them and create this nice combination of color. Now let's apply the effect. So for that, let's select all these and convert them into smart object. The layers which I have selected are these three layers and the background, and convert them into smart object. Now we'll apply 3D. So we'll go to 3D, new mesh from layer, depth map to plane, and here we go. We got a nice extruded text here. As you can see, the text are extruded outward. The previous one was extruded inward, this one is extruded outward. So as you can see, the principle is very simple. It's that whatever the dark color is going to be extruded inward and the lighter colors are to be extruded outward. So here it's the example, the black color is extruded back and the light colors are extruded out. Thus, that's how we're going to use this technique and create your amazing texts. So now right click and let's change it to unlit texture. Now we're going to zoom it in. So let's place it something like this. I'm going to use this, click on there, use this Z axis and zoom it in. Okay. And I'm going to use this Y axis and move it upward here. Yep. And now I'm going to use this 3D rotation tool just to give that look, just to get that look in my design. So what I want from this design is something like this. Okay, and I'm gonna select this and move it, just place it something here, zoom it out a little bit. Okay, and I'll just add a dark background below there. So I'm gonna add a new layer and come on backspace to add a background, and now I'm gonna select that layer and I'm gonna use this rotate tool, 3D rotation tool here. Okay, and just rotate it a little bit and just move around rotation. So it's very simple, and the best thing about it is you can go anytime and you can just set the angle you want. You want to give it something like this or this or this. So I think this is looking great. I'm going to keep it that way, and I'm going to set this position around here. And if I click on this other layers, you can see it's the glow effect. And here is our first design which you have created, and I think the second design comes out very well compared to our first design. And this is the first design, this is the smash, and that's our original X. And that's how we have created this 3D extrusion text effect in Adobe Photoshop. It was very simple. We have used depth map option and created out some amazing text effect. The process was very simple, the technique was very simple. The only thing we need to understand in this tutorial is that it's the combination of color. It's lighter to darker. Darker represent depth and lighter represent extrusion outward. So that's the simple principle we have used, and we created this two amazing designs. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we'll be doing some more research on 3D extrusion text effect. We'll be creating out some amazing abstract design or background design. So don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.